Oh my God! What, ladies? Calm down. Calm down.
Okay, put your shirt on. Go. Put it on your shirt.
Can I do this on my own?
Yeah, put your shirt on. Right. We'll close the curtain, but we're staying here. Yo, you can't get out of bed. We gotta help you put your pants on.
I have to put them on.
No.
He's packing.
No. I'm staying right here. Packing. Put your shirt on. I'll turn around. Look, you want your mom to help you?
Come on.
No.
You gave birth. You gotta do it.
Look, I don't want to see what you got. They gonna help you. But wait, there's more.
There is a big possibility that I'm high right now, but I'm pretty sure Jesus is in the corner of my room.
That's not my child.
Алдына сен маған не айтқан едің? Инстаграмда?
Сің туралы айтқан шығар.
Чего?
Сің туралы айтқан шығар.
Брат, нырок, нырок, делай нырок.
What the hell?
He needs some milk.
Oh, shut up. What? Listen, that's not a real guy. When the security man is slammed by a woman, it's either staged or you just need a better security guy. That guy should just leave his man card away, cause he's now a bitch.
One time I felt like I was raped when
Yo, look at everybody's reactions when he said that.
They're laughing. They're laughing.
I'm so serious though. Yeah. Like,
no,
see?
I believe it. Okay. Like, yeah. Both ways. It does go both ways.
Listen, I got real drunk. I got real drunk, right? And went to this club called Seven. It's in Cincinnati. And I woke up at my baby mom's house, my first baby mama house, and I woke up naked, and that's all I remember.
Oh my God.
And when I woke up, I'm like, how the fuck I get here? Mm-hmm. Bitch, you raped me. That's
much.
What I told her.
I'm so sick of him.
And next thing you know, Armani was born. I'm dead serious too. I'm sorry, Armani. But but he was born, but I always tell her, I'm like, bitch, you raped me.
You know, when it happens to a girl, and rightfully so, like, yo, that's fucked up, blah, blah, blah. But if it happens to a guy, nobody bats an eye.
I mean, it sucks when it's happening both ways, but most likely when you're at the club and you drink and you do all that sexual stuff, like, you know in what situation you're putting yourself into. I'm not saying that she's right or wrong or that he's right or wrong. I'm just saying, like, between men and women, there's a difference. Now, Broner is a good boxer, so obviously the whole rape thing is gonna be like, well, you're stronger than the woman, so
Karens who got what they deserved. Karen didn't like this trash can in the road.
I can't control where the city puts it. It's trash.
Oh, instant karma.
Karen steps in front of motorcycle only to get her foot run over. Karen gets owned at the skate park.
Oh, no.
We're in the back of your way.
Because you put your hands on
it. You're the one that called me.
Yes.
Whoa!
Are you asking for it? You asked for it.
Me! Oh! Oh my.
She's on Facebook Live.
Honey, I'm from Tennessee, and I don't look like you.
Take her away, boys. Take her away.
Just saying, you can tell me what to do and I gotta do what you say. Is that what you said?
If you're gonna insert yourself into the
I haven't inserted myself not one time. Not all the Madison police, but most of y'all don't give a fuck, man. You need to learn how to de-escalate. That's what you need to learn how to do.
Because
the way you talking and your body movement, your hand gestures, all that ain't even necessary. I'm talking to you like a human, but you want
to
have
like
a fucking attitude, I can get one too. Police
I'm done
is.
Talking to you.
Well, walk off. You walked forward. Up to me. I didn't come to you. Get the fuck out my face. Get out my face.
I'm not in your
don't
face.
Don't cops blame me. Get the fuck on somewhere. I'm a law-abiding citizen, woman.
Please don't address
I'm
me that
a,
way.
I'm a good guy. What, calling you a woman? What are you then?
I have not said anything to you that's been disrespectful.
I said I'm a law-abiding citizen, woman. How is that disrespectful?
Because I don't want to be called that.
So what you want me to call you then? A him, her, they? What do you want me to call
Sergeant.
You?
Sergeant.
I ain't gonna call you that.
Bye, officer lady. Notice how she keeps her hands in the pocket? That's a submissive move, by the way. When you are in a situation like that, your hands should never be like around you or like this, they should just move freely and ready for action. You holding your hands in your pocket means that you're pretty much a victim, or you're the submissive one in that situation. You're not really being an actual police officer.
You won't step right here, I promise you that.
Go ahead, I do. Now what? What are you gonna do? Nike. Fucking thing.
Hey, you better keep moving, brother.
Or what? What are you gonna do?
It's gonna be
you
a problem.
You keep talking, but you ain't doing nothing.
It's gonna be a big problem.
Yeah, it is.
Don't touch my stomach with your stomach, because that's gonna be a problem.
Go ahead, do something, I dare you.
I just want you to keep moving, brother. I want you to grab my balls.
I bet you do, you little fucking homo.
If there was a black girl at this table and I was attempting to dismiss her point because of her skin color, you don't think that would be racist?
There's no dismissing a point. You were
saying that I don't have, because I'm white, I don't have...
You can't relate. You don't know what you're talking about.
I can have an opinion on things because I'm a human with a functioning brain and I'm capable of rational
Relatable,
thought.
That's what I meant.
Can you stop cutting
you
me
can't
off?
Relate.
Can you stop cutting me off, please?
Yes, Brian.
Bro, I mean, I'm not surprised your issues with men. You've got an attitude. I've been perfectly polite to you, but...
This is not an attitude, if you can't...
I mean, you're interrupting me. You're cutting me off. Yes,
I'm
Brian.
Cutting.
You're being a little
this
condescending.
This is a conversation. We're going back and forth.
Okay.
No, it's not. She's just massively insecure. She does it for clout and attention, especially because she's on a big podcast on the internet. So obviously, she wants traffic towards her accounts or towards her name or whatever it is. So obviously she's not gonna back down. Other than that, this is it. Like, if you're a man and you put up with this type of attitude in your life, you're just an idiot. You truly are an idiot.
Fuck off pie. With one cup of no one cares, a dash of kiss my ass, add some fuck yous, a pinch of blow me, you're gonna wanna stir it all together and shove it up your ass.
Perfect.
Oh, what an idiot. I'm not gonna lie, that she looks like a keeper. I would definitely wife her up and have like three Latina looking babies with her.
You ready to jingle your bells? Let's do this. Yeah.
Stroke my, lick my, suck my cock. It's the first time for you.
Oh my god.
Is that okay?
She wants it.
Yeah,
what's with this weird angle? That this looks like a Tarantino movie, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, you.
Oh,
this looks disgusting. Like, they bring such a shame to the whole UFC sport and mixed martial arts. Like, you would not see two men fighting like that. And if they were, they would be like Hall of Famers. The Hall of Shame, by the way.
I think the push at the end was a little excessive. We already won the match. Why you gotta...
It's just...
You
see him doing that? You're gonna break my neck.
Ladies, catch!
A lot of women don't cook anymore, man. And here's my thought. It's true, gentlemen. Look at us, hungry clap. You hear that hunger clap? And here's my thoughts, ladies. If God didn't want you to cook, then why did he naturally put milk and eggs in your body?